hope all of you are fine. Now I am here with the poem of chapter 7. The name of the poem is When I Set Out for Lammas. The poet is Thomas Hurdley. First I will read out the poem. When I set out for Lammas, 100 miles away, the rain was on the spray and starlight lit my lonesomeness. When I set out for Lammas, I hung 100 miles away. So the poet, he is saying that when I set out for Lammas, he was to visit renovation work was going on at the church, and he was to visit that place. As a young architect, the poet was to visit that Lammas to supervise the renovation work of the church. The place was 100 miles away. It was winter. The leaves were covered with snow. He was alone and shaky. His only companion was the starlight. So starlight was his only companion. He was afraid. Then also he was thinking, I will be successful or not. Then also he went, and after that we'll come to know what happened. What would be chance at Lammas while I should sojourn there? No prophet durst declare, nor did the wisest wizard guess. What would be chance at Lammas while I should sojourn there? He was unsure that situation he would have to face there during his stay in Lammas. No seer could there make a focused. Even the wisest magician could not make guess about future. He was worried whether he will come back or not, and he was to go there to witness, to visit that renovation work he was to see. As he was an architect, so it was his duty to look after or to go there to see. So he was saying that it's very difficult. It was not sure he will come back or not. Then also he didn't stop going. He went there. He was alone. Only that starlight was with him. And magician and wizard, they cannot even guess ki he will come back or not. But he went there. When I returned from Lammas with magic in my eyes, all marked with mute surmise, my radiance rare and fathomless. When I returned from Lammas with magic in my eyes. So, but when he returned from that place, he was very happy. His eyes shone with joy. Everybody tried silently to guess the reason of his deep and uncommon happiness. So it was not sure he will come back or not, but he came back. He came back with joy, and it was a satisfaction. It was the symbol of satisfaction when he came back. And when he came back, his eyes were full of joy, and at the same time he was having a crumbled paper. Only two things he was having, that was a new glow in his eyes and a crumbled piece of paper striking out his coat pocket. So only two things were there when he came back from that place, Paris, and it was that crumbled paper was with the note. That note is that poem. He was willing to express the experience, the happiness he visited over there during that time. He experienced his tried to express his inner feeling, inner joy through this poem. So it is that as a young apprentice or architect, British poet and novelist Thomas Harding once visited a Paris to supervise the renovation work, restoration or renovation work. On his return from the Paris, people noticed two things out him: a glow in his eyes and a crumbled piece of paper striking out of his coat. So that paper, it is recorded in one of his biographies, contained the draft of a poem. Going to read that very poem, that is the poem he wrote, and it was all about his satisfaction, all about his happiness over there. Thank you so much. Hope you understood. It's a nice poem. You can also do like this. Wherever you are going to visit a place, you can also write a poem. You can write it down in a poem form. Okay, so then you can remember. This is very difficult to write a story now, all the time it's not possible, but you can write a poem mentioning all the important points or experiences you witness over there. Okay, so thank you so much, dear.